Bismillahir Rahmanir Raheem.
The internet is a devil's playground. And in that playground there's an adab and a way in which to maneuver through that satanic field like a landmine. If you follow it, alhamdulillah, if you don't care for it then that's up to you. But don't later say that something happened and you got sidetracked. So anytime you're in the devil's playground, it's extremely dangerous. Everything that Prophet brought, the internet is the most dangerous zone of it because you'll be breaking Sharia. You'll be breaking all of Prophet laws and rules, and as a result every rizq will be stopped, every faiz will be stopped, every barakah will be stopped. Because the physical was easy to understand, oh that's that side, this this side, and they don't. Internet, nobody knows whose side is what side. And all the shaitan wants is that the person keeps stepping on the wrong side, they broke the Sharia. And as a result they begin to anger Prophet and they lose all barakah and faiz and everything. So anytime you're in the devil's playground, it's extremely dangerous. When we ask that people who are in that area and on those social medias, that our life is to keep the focus on the shaykh, keep the focus on your teacher so that your focus is exactly like the sun and the moon, and the shaykh's focus is with his shaykh, and the focus towards the reality of Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ. And you learn in your life, just keep your focus, don't deal with right and don't deal with left. This whole system is built to keep your focus, because at any moment this life of ours is like a tufan, like a tornado. That shaitan just wants you, look, 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 look this way, and as soon as you're distracted, it's enough to grab the person and they're off in a different tangent, different way. So then this teaching is for that understanding, that if you're in those platforms, when the shaykh is posting something, and this is the staff and the admins are posting these teachings, our job is to go in and make a comment on the shaykh's teaching. So this is the danger point, you make the comment, oh alhamdulillah, thank you very much, and you're out. And that was to show that you are participating in this virtual classroom, as if you were in his zawiya and he wants to see your face. You want to be recognized on social platform by the shaykh. So then you make your comment, and that helps that post because of its algorithms and its interaction, and you go out. Then there are people who are making comments on comments, and that's a danger. The concept of waswas and shayateen is enough to just you're focusing on something. Somebody comes, hey man, hey, hey man, hey man, hey what's up, hey, hey man. Why? Because you're focusing on something. So it's enough to just whisper that what? And now you're in a dialogue. So then instead of now focusing on your shaykh anymore, you're like, what? Oh you like that comment? Oh yeah, thank you. Oh you like here, then I think you. And then before you know it, the two of you are continuously commenting on each other now. Where that person now became the shaykh, you became the shaykh, you're now in a different relationship. You came into the devil's playground to focus on your shaykh, and you made your comment, you got out, and you listened to the event, you read the article, you watched the video. The others are very difficult, very different, and making comment on comments, trying to build relationships on social media, relationships absolutely don't need. You don't need a single friend in the internet world. because you don't know who you're even dealing with. It could be a profile of a woman and you don't know if it's a woman or a man, and it can have any type of profile image, and what we call catfishing now, and that's a danger.
As-salamu alaykum, we hope that you're enjoying the video inshaAllah. Just a request that you help us continue to make such amazing Islamic content inshaAllah. Share this video with your friends and loved ones, subscribe to the channels and donate. Every bit helps. Jazakallah khair, and we will return to the program.
This is a way that they're going to disseminate into shaitan's playground haqqaiqs. This group of people, they know each other, but internet world, I have no idea who's people. Some person calls him Ali Naqshbandi, then he calls himself Ali Dagestani. It's like, what? You have no right to use the Naqshbandi name, Dagestani name, other than your name, what your Baba gave to you, that's your name. Their names, you need permission from Mawlana Shah Naqshband to say that, I'm Nurjan Naqshbandi. But you can't just do that, and students can't do that, absolutely they can't do that. Why? Because imagine they put themselves name Naqshbandi and they go putting all sorts of crazy posts and giving hearts to women, chatting with this, chatting with that. Naqshbandi is doing this, who's this name that's doing this? So it's forbidden. So then these are all these traps and games that are happening on the internet, so pious people enter very carefully. They enter into this platform, they like the shaykh, they say, thank you very much, shukran, bye, I'm out. Anyone comment on your comment, don't reply, don't get sidetracked now and build the friendship, and you post on their post, they post on your post, and before you know it, the two of you are in a relationship commenting. One, the danger is now you lost the focus of the shaykh. You're too interested in if they're commenting on your post and you're commenting on their post. So you saw how shaitan just flipped, now your focus is no longer with the shaykh and you're dealing on a side, and two, you don't even know who you're dealing with. You haven't seen the true face of the person and you don't know what this relationship is, and this is not a place that we're encouraging relationships, because we don't know which one is halal and haram in this relationship. So this is not an encouragement for people to who don't know each other to start, you know, commenting back and forth. And the reason why the shaykh is saying is because it's on his posts where the playgrounds are happening and people chatting and then commenting on things. So this is the adab of the tariqah, just like the adab at the center. There's no intermixing, there's no socializing at the centers. Everyone stays into their own platform. They come to the tariqah to learn, to build the good manner, good characteristic and go home. Not to interact so much that they become affected by each other. And Mawlana Shaykh used to describe that the students, he puts them in a bag and shakes them, because they're coming to be cleansed. So they come, they interact, they don't like certain things, and that's okay because that's coming to polish the character. When you come and you interact, you're not happy with it, you get polished, you become, you have a sabr and patience. But in the internet world, that's something different. They don't want the interaction, they don't want people commenting on people's comments. Just make your own comment, original comment on the shaykh's post, that way you logged in, I'm here, alhamdulillah, thank you, bye, and out. And that becomes a grave danger because you see all these interactions and people don't even know who they're dealing with. And then these internet relationships, and it could be female to female, and all of a sudden, I'm a refugee, help me to come. What? Who's that, and why are they telling you they're a refugee and they want you to go where? And they want to come to your place? And then you haven't heard those announcements at the airport that, did you pack your bags and don't take anyone's bags, and any unannounced bags, please call security. It's one of those types of things. That somebody is coming to you from where? Why do they want help from you that they just met 5 minutes ago? So it means it's a devil's playground, and don't play in it. Just come to learn the haqqaiqs and then share the post so that we come against shaitan. Because you never know who reads the post and comes towards guidance. But we're not supposed to be in there playing and making everything dirty and get involved in the dirtiness. It will destroy everything, it will destroy the faith, it will destroy the rizq, it will destroy everything. So they stay away from it, they post and they get out, and they keep themselves to be safe in very difficult days, because all the shaitan wants is enter into a sin, this protection leave you and these rocks begin to hit you. And we are people who know that difficulty is everywhere, we want Divine grace and Divine majesty to be protecting and dressing and blessing. We pray that Allah inspire our hearts towards always goodness and to avoid any type of thing that we find any doubt in it and step away from it.
We have helped many of the needy around the world. You can make a difference right now by helping us support those who need it the most. Give now at nurmuhammad.com/donate. A Timeless Reality with Shaykh Nurjan Marahmadi guides the reader in meditation, connecting the heart to a guide and to daily spiritual practices to understand the effects of positive and negative energy and to progress the reader in their spiritual awakening and the soul's connection to the world of light. The Divine's Ancient Timeless Reality. Order on Amazon.com.
Build the love and the connection. You don't have to focus on 20 people, just be the moon and focus on one. Learn your way, build the relationship that you're solid. You know that in a time of difficulty, you've built a relationship and the prayer of that one is a push to God, is right behind you. He said that I know behind me is a fierce lion, my back is solid. Do you feel that way? Humble, because your love and the way that we interact. But could you imagine living through this life where I don't know what the heck is behind? Our life is about this whole system that I built, this love I built, this participation I built. I feel my back is solid. There are fierce lions behind me, right behind. If you're trying to get to me, you have to go through all of them. People can support and show that they have a love. People can get the books, post the books, make a review for the book. People can go to the sites and support the sites. All of that system makes all of this to be possible. It's not running for free and there's no government that's supporting us. This is just by the hearts of people. If their hearts are touched by it, they have a love for it, then alhamdulillah they build that relationship. What you do in the physical zawiyah, because this is the adab of the tariqah, that the shaykh and the physical students, they know, they come, they give a gift and they say, "Shaykh, pray for me." And this was the teaching that we taught before, that if you can find these Ahlul Bayt and give your love to them, give your support to them, keep the companionship with that reality, then whatever Allah dressing them and wherever their spirituality and physicality is going, Allah give a share in that reality to those people whom support and love. The support to the charity is something that is mandated through our rizq. What we owe from what we made, we have to give food and water and drink and support. The two are not the same. Supporting a shaykh is not charity, he's not allowed to take sadaqah, but they're all family of Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ. It's called hadiyah. And a gift that builds love and admiration and respect. So for the work that you do, the character that you have, I want to give this gift to the hand of Ahlul Bayt, and alhamdulillah this builds a relationship of love. Because now the zawiyah is virtual, that's why then that service is online, that they can do that support through online. then from the rizq and the sustenance that we make, we have a share that has to go back to people, to feed them, to give water to them, to have food programs, truck programs, and all of the masjid support, all of those things. So this builds the relationship, this builds the community, this builds the strength of our community. Because our community is very strong, alhamdulillah, Allah positioned us for these events, right? When everybody was running around and traveling and making fitna, we were building a media engine and producing videos and everything, and Allah then sent onto this world a shutdown. And then what did everybody want? Media. And so alhamdulillah, the beautiful sounds that come out, with the quality of the sound that comes out, that puts out a message and some beautiful ambient sound, and everything alhamdulillah comes out. So these are Allah had prepared us for that day. You prepare, you don't know why we're doing it. It's like building a Noah's ship and there was no rain. And Allah said, day would come. Day is going to come, they're going to be pounding on the door to get a ta'weez. Because everything was great. When everything's great, you don't think about your akhirah. Oh, lo and behold, death at your door, you want to get 10 ta'weezes on your neck, you want to put a sticker on every wall. Because this is the business of akhirah. We're in the spirituality of death in the grave, we don't make sense to people here. But if you're about to put your foot on that side, ahlan wa sahlan, we're here for you. But that's our life, is that side, not this side. So the people heavy on this side, they don't care for these things, they're not interested in these things. But when the earth is beginning to shake, like death is coming everywhere, well of course, where's that video? Where's this thing? Where's this thing? This organization is spreading out turbans in hundreds, are now wearing Ahl Sunnah, wearing the amama, putting ta'weez on, putting stickers on, putting all these things on. Every event that comes, that app goes out to 20,000 people to find their awrah. Allah gave this honor, alhamdulillah, it was all positioned there, the app is there, it's telling everybody. So they click on it, they like us, they don't like us, they're using the app. Find out what the awrad from Muharram was. So alhamdulillah. So the entity is busy, we're busy. So when they're asking for support, it's not for retirement, it's for the projects and all of the things that the entity is doing. All the food, now we have two trucks. We have a truck that's running in Vancouver and a truck running in Los Angeles, and Asim's active in Los Angeles and Haji Hayat active in Vancouver, and all the brothers that are helping, and they're picking up food now left and right. They all are now throwing in muffins and breads and soups and alhamdulillah. You build it and Allah will send. Because these are the nations of plenty, but from one source it doesn't get to the mouth of the poor. So all you need is a van to drive them back and forth and pick it up. So alhamdulillah, Allah dress us. By means of these actions, these are a protection for ourselves and for our family. For a day in case we don't have food, we don't have water, we don't have shelter. And all the other actions build the love and the connection. And that's tariqah. Subhana rabbika rabbal izzati amma yasifoon, wa salaamun al mursaleen, walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen, bi hurmati Muhammad al Mustafa wa bi siri Surat al Fatiha.
If money could just grow on trees, there would be no need for this message. Since it doesn't, let us show you where your generous donations are going. We film, edit, and produce weekly television shows of divinely knowledge throughout Canada and the UK, as well as live stream internationally on Facebook and YouTube. Shaykh Nurjan's ever-growing online presence is the result of continuous financial input, and with your financial assistance and participation, this rapid growth will continue. Our Muhammadan Way app is continuously being upgraded and improved, providing an all-encompassing Islamic guide. In addition to the Muhammadan Way app, nurmuhammad.com is a website of immense knowledge and comprehensive Islamic teachings that is updated daily. Your ongoing support also enables a team of editors to compile books of heavenly wisdom from Shaykh Nurjan's teachings. One of our longest ongoing initiatives has been to provide basic necessities to the most in need worldwide. From feeding people in Vancouver's downtown east side, to clothing LA's homeless community, and supporting a children's orphanage in Pakistan. Your ongoing donations will help us continue to spread the love and example of the Holy Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him. Become a shareholder in immense blessings. nurmuhammad.com/donate.